by Night by Harry McMullen. Like a thick black blanket hiding a body, a dense cloud hid the exhausted sun, casting darkness over the land. The ghost-like trees whispered a macabre lullaby as a malevolent breeze stirred their bare branches. Hawk-like silhouettes lurked on the edge of the dilapidated gravestones protecting their once-loved bodies. Almost instantaneously, there was a shift in the air. It was darker now. It was colder. Like a tiger surrounding its prey, the mist engulfed the gravestones, covering the once intricately edged weather-worn patterns. It had begun. When the forgotten gravestones finally crumbled, when the daunting silhouettes finally stopped dancing, when silence fills the land, then you know danger is lurking. Amidst the darkness, two figures emerged. Slowly and carefully, the two people peered for the unknown. The decaying ivy crawled upon the dilapidated gravestones, reaching for the last streak of light. With extreme trepidation, the boys quickened their pace and made their way through the sinister cemetery. Regretting the choice of taking a shortcut, Jack and Joe feared everything around them. The ghost-like trees scratched the two impoverished boys. The whisper of the wind reverberated around their minds, haunting them forever. Suddenly, a scream echoed around them. Everything stopped. Everything froze. The two boys froze. The scream faded. The two boys clutched their fists. The dead was lurking and everyone knew it. Scanning in all directions, a cold, fearful shiver crawled through Jack's body, devouring him like a deadly disease. Not daring to look behind him, Joe forced himself through this death palace. He knew something was coming, and it was close. Then they heard again, but this time it was louder. It was closer. It was here. Suddenly, a wave of mist engulfed them. Fear took over their bodies as they got separated through the suffocating fog filling the air. Bang! There was something there. As sudden as it came, mist disappeared. Jack took a sigh of relief. But there was something different. Joe was dead. Cowardly, Jack fled from this horrific sight. Regret, fear, disbelief struck him as he dropped to the ground, flooding it with tears. Then the scream bursted from under him. Suddenly, a cold green hand reached out and grabbed him, pulling him in forever.